G'day there, everyone. Pete Moriarty here from itGenius. If you don't already know us, we help organizations systemize, organize, and scale using Google Workspace and other tools. And if you are a member of our Google Workspace community group, welcome. Thanks so much for being here. And I'm going to be answering some community questions. I haven't answered any community questions for a while, and so I'm going to dive in and answer as many questions as I can in 10 minutes. And if you're not already subscribed to our YouTube channel, make sure you jump on the link below. If you've not already registered for our upcoming bootcamp, please make sure you check that out as well. And there'll be a link to that down below as well. So I'm going to jump in and answer as many questions as I can, starting out with Leanne's question right here. And Leanne asks, I'm looking to set up multiple super admins on Google Workspace. Is it possible to enable the whole of Drive to be visible to all super admins without having to share every document and every image? So that's a great question, Lynn. It's pretty common desire for business owners or admins to want to be able to kind of see everything in a business or see everything in an organization. You're not able to see into the My Drives of other staff or other, you know, people who are registered for your business or organization in Workspace. But what you can do is, if you ever needed to, you could reset a password and get into that person's account. But if you wanted to have like a kind of overarching view of everything and see everything, then the best way to do that is to actually configure shared drives inside of Google Drive. Now, when you configure shared drives, you actually are able to designate who can see what across the business. And when you train your staff and your team to get into the habit of actually storing everything into shared drives, what that does is it gives you the ability to add yourself to every one of the shared drives that you set up. And then effectively you're able to see into everything inside the business. So that's probably how I would achieve that. Remember, you also have the option of enabling Google Vault, which will actually store every document or a copy of every document right across the business. And you could use Google Vault to actually see into each user's individual documents if needed. It's not as user-friendly or intuitive as using something like Google Drive to just kind of browse through the documents. But if you need to search for documents with a particular keyword or something like that, then that certainly allows you to do that. So there you go, that's one way. Cool, all right. So I have another question here, and this one is from Michael and Winter. And they ask, what is the simplest way to use Google Workspace to create a fillable template form for directors to use weekly and save in different shared folders? This is a great question. If you want to create a template form, have it automatically save into different shared folders. I'm not sure exactly what you're trying to achieve here, but obviously any form template is going to be best done inside of Google Forms. You can use some features like macros or Google Script to actually trigger different things happening in different spreadsheets, for example. So that may be one way of doing it. There may also be some third-party add-ons, for example, using the form add-on marketplace, which is inside the Workspace marketplace, to send form responses to different places based on different sets of validation. And what's kind of coming to mind for me is maybe one of the ones that automatically creates them into a PDF. Maybe you would be able to put them into different folders, the respective folders that you need them to go in into Drive using one of those add-ons. Failing that, if that doesn't work, you could use an external tool like Zapier. And Zapier is excellent at creating automations and workflows between different apps and different needs inside the business. And if you need any help with Zapier, our team are really great. We can actually help configure these kind of different workflows for your business. If you're looking for someone to just kind of get it done for you, it might be easy to just delegate it off to someone else. Okay, cool. So the next question we have here is from Javier, or maybe it's Xavier, I'm not sure. Since the old version is changing to Workspace, so the old version of G Suite is now changing to Workspace, what's the advantage besides, you know, having additional storage compared to Gmail? And I'm going to assume this person is asking, what's the main difference between using a private personal Gmail account as opposed to switching over to, like, you know, a single license on a Workspace account? I would say be very, very careful using a Gmail account for anything important. I personally do not use a Gmail account for anything in my life because I've heard horror stories, and we've had customers who have called us and said, hey, I've been locked out, or someone's hacked me, or I've tried to contact Google support and I can't get back into my account. And that's a real problem, particularly if you've got things like family memories stored in Google Photos, if you've got important documents like, I don't know, maybe your home insurances and those kind of things stored in Google Drive, maybe you've got other important emails that you've used a Gmail account for. Personally, I just don't really trust a consumer service like that for anything important. Yeah, sure, maybe I would connect it to a Google Home, and have it do some things around my house, but I wouldn't put any data in there that I care about. And what I do instead is I use a Google Workspace account, so a paid Google Workspace account. It's only $8 per month. And I use that for my personal domain. So I have a personal domain. It's called moriarty.co. And I use that personal domain for my all my home stuff, right? So my Google Photos, my personal files that sit in Google Drive. You know, like when I go and capture drone footage or GoPro footage on my motorbike, I'll put that into Google Drive there. And then, of course, anything to do with like running my house and running my investments and anything to do with my home life, I'll have that all in a personal business account. And so that's the best way to do things. There is a video up on our channel about that, about how to configure a personal workspace account. So you can use that. But that would be my strong recommendation. Google is moving everybody over to Google Workspace. So whether you were on Gmail previously and you've been affected by the price change and you need to move over to the new plans, or if potentially you had a free legacy account from many, many moons ago, some accounts were created free, some of them with 5 users, some of them with even 50 users or more. Those accounts are now all being transitioned into Google Workspace. So that would be a good idea. Cool. So we have a question here from Fam, and they ask, can you help me? Before we used Google Suites, G Suite with 30 accounts. They had the main domain name, but using an alias. So alias.vn. So they've got primary domain there, and then alias.vn. When we send mail to alias.vn, it's redirecting to primary, but now switching to Workspace, and it seems to be that the primary domain has changed here in some way. So once you are using either G Suite or Google Workspace and you have both of your domains configured, it's actually pretty easy to switch between the domains. If you have 30 users, I would recommend you either read through all of the administrative guides or get in touch with our team to help facilitate the process. But it's pretty straightforward to change a primary domain. You can, an alias domain and convert that to a primary domain if you wish. You can switch and change between your different domains, but you never lose any of them. Many business owners, when they rebrand or they add on a sub-brand or a secondary brand, they believe that they need to completely change things up and completely, start up a new fresh account. That's actually not needed. It's very easy to update your domains. You just need to follow the help guides with Google or delegate it to our team. Our team have a whole process. There's a big checklist of things to make sure that you don't lose any data, you don't miss any emails, and you don't, make things difficult for your team, because, in the worst case scenario, a team can get locked out of their accounts and that can be confusing for your staff. And yeah, you definitely don't want that. So next up, we've got a poll that was created here by Atwan in our group, and they're saying, what's the best way to train and fully immerse oneself in Workspace? And there's lots of options here. Are you looking for, training via YouTube? Plenty of training videos on YouTube. We also have a channel which is pretty busy there. Someone has said, get Google certified is another suggestion. Google support links, probably wouldn't recommend that. Might get a bit boring at the end of the day. What I would say is one thing that's not on that list is actually joining Genius Academy. And so inside our Genius Academy, if you are an IT Genius subscriber, you don't have to pay anything to be on any of our paid plans. You just have to transfer your billing to us. But you actually get access to all of our professional training videos. And these are created not just for YouTube. These are professional videos in a professional Google Classroom library for you and your staff to get up to speed with all the latest in Google Workspace and for you to really know how to work with it correctly. And so those have been created specifically for the purpose of getting you and your staff up to speed on the most important features. And so I would recommend you check out Genius University. If you need the link to that, just jump on the link below this video and look out for the transfer in offer. That transfer in offer gets you a bunch of perks for transferring your billing through to IT Genius. Doesn't cost you any extra. You even get access to a number of perks and features. Just in case you're interested in that, I would highly, highly recommend it. Okay, cool. So what do we have here next? I have backup and sync files that I shared with others. How do I migrate to a new computer without losing my links to the files? Well, Google Backup and Sync is switching to being just Google Drive now on the desktop. So previously there was Google File Stream and Google Backup and Sync. They've both been merged back into one. And effectively, the app allows you to stream your files down to your computer from wherever you are. So as long as Google has finished its synchronization and completed its sync and all of those files are now uploaded, then you can just sign in on your new computer and all the files will be there. Now, if you want to have a local copy of those files, if you want them to be actually available on the local machine, well, what you'll need to do is choose those folders again and make sure with each one of those folders you have it set to keep offline and remain offline. When you do that, then it's going to download it to your actual computer. But there's no need to kind of like relink files or anything like that. You just need to sign on your computer. Pretty straightforward. Okay, cool. Next question here from Gareth. This is a really common question. How do you share email inboxes across a team? Great question, Gareth. So glad you asked. The best way to do this is using a feature called delegated access. And so I would recommend that any mailbox that needs to be a shared mailbox is set up as a separate user for your business. And that, so it might be help at or support at or contact at or sales at your business. That's one that you want to set up as a separate and discrete mailbox. With that, I would recommend that you log into that account and then delegate it back to the staff that need to access it. And I would recommend that you are the only person that logs into that. Many business owners will just share passwords, sharing multiple people logging into one account at the same time, and it can turn into a little bit of a mess. We don't want that to happen. Okay, cool. Thanks so much for checking this out, guys. If you're interested in learning more, please make sure you're subscribed to our channel. Jump on the link below if you'd like to either connect to our YouTube channel, reach out to our team for any help that you need, or join us on our upcoming bootcamp. Great way to have you and your team learn about everything to do with the Google Workspace world. I am presenting the bootcamp. It's been a long time since I've done any in-person presentations. Oh, this is live and online on Zoom, I guess. But it's been a long time since I've done any live presentations, and I look forward to having you there if you join us. Until next time, I'll see you in the next video, and thanks very much for joining.